Hello and welcome. Are you looking for a way to control your mobile phone from your computer? Do you have a Samsung device or another device that's running on Android? Well then, you can use Samsung Flow to control your tablet or mobile phone from your computer. Okay, in step one, we're gonna head over to our phone to download and install Samsung Flow. I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back. We're on my Samsung Galaxy S22 Plus. Now I'm going to show you how to download Samsung Flow on your mobile phone. So on your Android device, go to the Play Store. And then in the search bar in the Play Store, type in Samsung Flow. Now you want Samsung Flow from Samsung Electronics Co.ltd. You want to click on the install button now.
2 seconds later.
Okay, after it installs, you should open it up. And here are some instructions that you can also follow to connect to the computer. Basically just explaining the capabilities that you'll have once you connect your phone to your computer. You can share documents, pictures, videos, and it can be any Android device, such as a tablet. Doesn't have to be just your phone. You sync your notifications, you'll get your notifications from your phone onto your other computer or tablet, and you get to share your screen, which you'll have full control to your mobile device or tablet from your computer. Let's push the continue button. Okay, allow Samsung Flow to find, connect to, and determine the relative position of nearby devices. We're gonna have to allow that. Allow Samsung Flow to send you notifications. We have to allow that. We are all set on our Android device. Now, we have to go to a computer and download Samsung Flow. Alright, so after downloading and installing Samsung Flow onto your cell phone or tablet, you want to then go to your PC and install Samsung Flow. In order to do that, you want to go down to your search icon and you want to type in store. And that will give you the Microsoft Store app. You want to open up the Microsoft Store app, left click on it. Now you want to search for Samsung Flow. The Samsung Flow app, so left click on it. And make sure it's Samsung Flow from Samsung Electronics Co., Ltd., period. Press the get button. Alright, now it's downloading. Now you want to open it up once it has finished installing. So there are three different ways that we'll be able to interact with our mobile phone. You can use Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, or just connect with a USB cable. So let's click on start now. My phone and computer are on the same network, so Samsung Flow has already found my Galaxy phone. So let's click on our phone, choose an option, either Wi-Fi or LAN or Bluetooth. Let's use Wi-Fi, which is more reliable than Bluetooth connection. Left click on Wi-Fi. All right, now we have to register the device. Confirm the pass key to connect with Samsung S22, which is my cell phone. Okay, and you can see on my phone. So you just want to make sure that the numbers are matching your computer and your phone, and then you can press the OK button on your phone. Alright, now press the OK button on the computer. Now on the phone, you have to set up some more permissions or allow permissions. Samsung Flow wants to be able to record audio while using the app is usually the option you want to choose. If you choose any other option, then you'll have to keep allowing permission every time you connect your phone to Samsung Flow in order to use it on PC. So while using the app is the best option. I'm gonna press while using on app now. Okay, allow Samsung Flow to access your phone call logs. I'm gonna allow that. Okay, allow Samsung Flow to access your contacts. You want to allow that. Allow Samsung Flow to make and manage phone calls, allow. And you need to allow all of these things because you want to be able to do everything that you would be able to do on your phone on your PC. So that's why all these permissions are needed. So let's continue. Allow Samsung Flow to send messages and view SMS messages. So that's for your text messages. You want to allow that. Okay. Permission needed to send app notifications to connected devices. Go to settings and turn on notification access for Samsung Flow. All right, so we need to enable this in order to get our phone notifications to go to our PC. So let's go to settings. Let's scroll to the Samsung Flow application. And you can see it's off. We want to turn it on. So we're going to allow notifications. So you just want to hit the allow button on this screen. Okay, now you can see that the toggle has switched to on for Samsung Flow. And this is, as you can see, it's for the notification access. Okay, go back. You can share files or messages from your phone to your connected device. So let's do a test message. In my phone, I'm going to type in test. And let's see what comes up on the computer. So send, and we got our message from the phone on the computer. Now let's send a message back. Test from PC. And send. All right, and you can see we received that on our phone. Now let's dive into some of the other features which we are now capable of because we have connected Samsung Flow from our phone to our computer. So you can put your phone aside now that you're connected to your phone from your PC. You can do everything that you would be able to on your phone. So the first thing you can do is check your messages. All right, I have a lot of messages. Go back. Okay, the next thing you have is clipboard. You can turn on and off clipboard, which allows sharing between your clipboard on your phone and clipboard on your computer. They're virtual spaces in memory. The clipboard, you usually want to leave that on so that you're able to copy and paste from your phone to your computer and your computer back to your phone. And the next feature is the smart view. When we click on Smart View, well, kind of slow, but when we get our Smart View, oh, okay, sorry. So the first time you connect with Smart View, you have to go to your phone and you have to allow or start casting with Samsung Flow. So I'm going to say start now on my phone. Now I am viewing my phone from my PC, and I have all of the same buttons as I do on my phone, so I can minimize the Samsung Flow application, and then I can say go to YouTube, right? And I can view just the way I would on my phone. You can also check which apps you have open, same way you would on your phone. And you can close all your apps. So it's really great because if you get a lot of messages, you don't have to pick up your phone. You can just have the messages come through onto your computer and then you can respond to them like you were on your phone. Okay. Resolution. Turn it up to high. Okay, so you can change the resolution. You can do full screen. I was not able to show you how to exit full screen mode with my screen capture or recording software for YouTube going. So I took a screenshot for you to see what it looks like when you keep your mouse hovered above the top edge of the screen. The bar drops, there's a bar that drops down, and then over on the top right, you can use the two arrows that are facing each other to minimize or to go back to the standard size. And you can also drag on the screen if you want to stretch it, but the screen aspect ratio is going to stay the same no matter what. So okay, are we still recording?